So solid state. So first itself, I want to come to the point. What questions will be asked for a board exam? Second thing is, what question will be asked for entrance examination? Okay. So two things I just want to focus today. That's it. So I don't want to go to the topics which are not required and won't be asked for the board exam, nor for the entrance exam. I don't want to go to the topic and waste your time. So since I'm following the last 20 year pattern, entrance exam as well as for the last 5 to 6 years of board exam thing, I know clearly what questions will come, what won't come. So guys, I want your attention only for a few minutes. That's it. It's a very easy topic which I'm going to take. Okay. Packing efficiency of simple cubic lattice. So efficiency, first thing we should know, what is efficiency? So efficiency meaning is nothing but output by input. Output by input. For example, two bikes are there. One bike, if I put 1 liter of petrol, it will give 20 kilometer. But other bike may will give 40 kilometer. Okay. So there is a difference, right? So we can say that fuel efficiency is more with the bike, which will give me more kilometer. Just like that, efficiency basic meaning is what? Output by input. So the chapter name is solid state. So what I want to tell you in this chapter is, for example, let's take this, this is written as packing efficiency of simple cubic lattice. Okay. So we should know what is meant by packing efficiency first. Okay. So this total space filled by the particle is called what? Packing efficiency. So what is my packing efficiency meaning? The total space filled by the particle. Total space filled by the particles. This is called the packing efficiency meaning. Since I drawn this, this is a very simple diagram. A cube I had drawn first. Then two things is there. This is one atom. This is another atom. Both are same size. I didn't draw it clearly. Okay. And this A is there. No, this is called the edge length of the cube. Edge length. Here this is also A. This is also A. And this is nothing but radius. R is radius. That's all. Radius of each atom. This is sphere. And then what we have to know is, we have to know the volume of sphere. 4/3 πr³. That also we know. And there's a simple formula for packing efficiency. Volume of one atom to total volume of unit cell. Total volume of unit cell. We know that in a cube, what is the volume of the cube? Right on the next page. Volume of the cube is a cube, right? Correct. But if I take this as an edge length, what is my a is equal to 2r. a is equal to 2r. I have to do one second. A is equal to 2r. So which means volume of the cube will become 2r the whole cube. So which is nothing but 8r³. So this simple thing I have to substitute here. Volume of one atom to the total volume of the unit cell. Okay guys. So what is my packing efficiency? I'll write on the next page. Packing efficiency is equal to 4/3 πr³ whole divided by 8r³ into 100. This 8r³ I'm getting from here, and 4/3 πr³ is nothing but the volume of one atom. That is a sphere. Volume of sphere is 4/3 πr³. If I solve this thing, I'll get 52.4%. So this is the packing efficiency of a simple cubic lattice or SC. 52.4% is the packing efficiency of simple cubic lattice SC. Is it clear to everyone? Whatever I taught. Later on, you can. I'll give you this, the video. Okay, fine. Or else you can take a screenshot and keep. Later on, you can copy it down. So guys, by, I think around by 3:30 p.m. Yeah, by 3:30 p.m. I have started preparing these things. You got the point. I drawn each and everything, and made sure that this will benefit you, because I don't want any of your time gets wasted. Because if you're going to take up engineering, you're not going to get any of these things. Okay. So what I have to teach you is to make sure that whatever I teach you should come on the board exam first thing. Because board exam is very important, and we have to get 75% in above pakka for damn sure to get minimum. Minimum. I'm just saying 75% is minimum thing. Okay. Second thing is entrance also we have to focus and make sure that we shine in both the examination. Fine. And we need something called self-studying time. Okay. So that's the thing. So coming to the next thing, packing efficiency in body centered cubic. So here I can see three items. So later on, I will tell you what is this body centered thing, face centered and simple cubic thing. Okay, fine. So currently just let us solve what is there for the examination point of view. Okay, later on we will discuss what is not important. That is in some other session. Okay, so first in the first 10 minutes, I have to make sure that you guys are perfectly what understanding whatever I teach. So here also edge length is A. Okay, edge length is A, fine. And this blue color length, I'll put it as B itself. Okay, this I'll put it as B itself. And I'll just take some triangles here. Okay, I'll just take some triangles here. A. B, C, D, I'll put it off. A, B, C, D. This is one thing. E, F, G, and H. So A, B, C, D, E, F. It's up to you on how do you want to do it, okay? Fine. Edge length is fine. And this diagonal. Diagonal, I'm putting it as B. That is my FD, I'm putting it as B. And this full thing, which one? This 4R is there, right? This 4R, I just draw that thing also. This I'm putting it as C. Okay, so in triangle EFD, first thing. I'm just using Pythagoras theorem here. In triangle EFD, FD square is equal to EFD. I hope everyone knows where it is. EF square plus BD square. FD is nothing but my longest line. This is my FD. So there is B square. EF and ED are my edge length. A square plus A square. 2A square. Now I'm taking one more triangle. In triangle AFD. In triangle AFD. So I'll just show you where is AFD. A is here. AFD, this triangle I'm taking. Okay, so the longest side is obviously we can see C is the longest side. So AF square is equal to AD square plus FD square. FD square, we know what it is, B square. Correct? That B square is nothing but what? 2A square respectively. So I can directly put A square plus 2A square. This is A square plus 2A square. This is about 3A square. What is my AF? AF is nothing but C square. Fine. So I hope you're clear up to this. Kindly listen first. Later on, we can copy it down. So C is equal to 3A square. C square is equal to. This implies C is equal to what? Root 3A. Up to this, we are clear. Now, what is my C again from the diagram? From the diagram, this full C is nothing but R plus R plus R plus R. R is radius. 4R. C is equal to 4R. but C is equal to 4R. Now it's very easy for us to do. Correct? So this 4R is equal to what? Root 3. So what is my A is equal to? This implies, what is my A is equal to? 4R by root 3. This I'm going to put it in box and keep. Okay. Now, volume of the unit cell. Again, we need the packing efficiency formula. Okay. Packing efficiency formula, we know. What is the formula for the same? Just like in the last figure, it is volume of, but here there are two spheres are there. Correct? There are two spheres in the unit cell. It is volume of two spheres in the unit cell. If you ask me why, I'll tell you. Because this is BCC, body centered, in the sense there are two atoms per unit cell. Okay, so that I'll write down here. In body centered cubic, there are two atoms per unit cell. There are two atoms per unit cell. So that is the reason I am putting volume of two spheres to the total volume. So volume sphere is what? Two spheres is 2 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. Whole divided by a cube. What is my a cube? I'll just draw it here so that it will be clear for you. My a cube value, I'll just substitute these things. That's all. So once I substitute these things, I'll get what? I'll get the answer as 68%. I'll get the packing efficiency as 68%. And all of these things we have to by heart and keep. We don't solve anything. We just by heart and keep. So whenever we want to by heart, we'll by heart those things and keep it. So guys, you have to know that in BCC, there are two atoms. That's the only thing. So that I will explain later class. But in this thing, I just want to make sure that we have to know the packing efficiency of simple cubic, BCC, and the last one is face-ended cubic. And the next topic will be either the problem or for the board exam as well as entrance examination. If I'm done with this, your time is saved and you'll be much ahead of others. Any doubts you have, we will solve it in the last. Okay, no need to worry. Please do not worry at all. Face-ended cubic. There are four atoms per unit cell. I'll write it down that in FCC. In FCC, there are four atoms per unit cell. Okay, just for information, I'm just telling you, that's all. Okay, fine. And this full thing, which I have written by brown color, I'll put as B itself. Brown color B. Then I'll just measure A, B, C, D, or whatever it is. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Whichever you feel like, you can just put it out. Okay. So this B is nothing but my phase diagonal in this. This B is nothing but my phase diagonal. So guys, just two more minutes, I will finish it off. Okay. Just two more minutes you give me, I'll finish it off. So in triangle ABC, again, Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to BC square plus AB square. AC, we all know, it is B square. Already marked it B square. BC is nothing but side A, correct? AB is also A. Edge length is A. I'm not writing it down. A square plus A square. So B is equal to root 2A. Now coming back to one more thing. This is one radius. This is one more radius. This is the radius and this is the radius. So B is equal to what? 4R. B is equal to 4R. Now root 2A is equal to what? This implies root 2A is equal to 4R. So A is nothing but 2 root 2R. This implies A is nothing but 2 root 2R. I'll write next page. A is nothing but 2 root 2. This you have to remember. That's all. So guys, this is a very simple topic. We need not panic at all. So as I told you, only remember in face and dead cubic is what? There are 4 atoms per unit cell. Correct? So volume of one sphere is 4/3 pi r³. So I'll just write down the packing efficiency formula in this also. Packing efficiency formula. Since in face and there are 4 spheres, that's it. So volume of 4 spheres in unit cell to the total volume into 100. To the total volume into 100. So A is equal to 2 root 2 R. Okay, guys, you need to forget that. This implies packing efficiency is equal to 4 × 4/3 pi r³. Whole divided by total volume. 2 root 2 r the whole cube. That's all. Okay, and multiply by 100 because in percentage we are calculating. That's all. So you'll get the answer as 74%. But just remember this thing. So guys, in the packing efficiency of FCC, what I told you first, there are 4 atoms in per unit cell for face ended cubic. B is the diagonal length. A is the edge length. Correct? And what is B is equal to 4R? Common sense. First you triangle ABC. ABC you do it. You get what? By Pythagoras theorem you can find the value of B with respect to edge length A. So B is equal to root 2A. B is equal to 4R. Substitute root 2A is equal to 4R. You will get A. Why we are calculating this? Because we have to find a total volume. Volume of a sphere is what? 4/3 pi r³. But here we are having 4 atoms per unit cell. So 4 × 4/3 pi r³. Whole divided by what? Volume of the cube, that is A cube, 2 root 2 R the whole cube. So if you do that, you'll get the answer as 74%. Simple as a pie. Is everyone clear up to this derivation? Or any doubt? One more topic which is going to come either for your entrance examination or board exam. That's it. Density of unit cell in cubic crystal. Once I'm done with this, we'll do one problem. Yeah, Emmanuel, I'll explain to you. Once this session is over, I'll explain to you one more time. Okay. Yes, let me complete this thing. I'll explain each and everything one more time. No need to worry. For everyone, I'll explain all of these things one more time. I just want to complete this session within 5 more minutes. That's it. Then I'll explain to you everything. No need to worry. I'll explain to you. First thing. density formula. Draw this triangle. If you don't know this thing, draw one triangle. Then write down what? Density is equal to mass by volume. Or mass is equal to density into volume. MDS. So density is equal to what? Mass by volume. Correct? But for this, in solid state, we have to calculate some other thing. Okay, in solid state, what is our mass? Everything I'll explain to you. Our mass is in unit cell or mass of an atom. Mass of an atom. So, which will have Avogadro number with us? M is equal to capital M by Na. Na stands for Avogadro number. Volume is A cube itself. Volume is A cube itself. Now this implies this equation will become D is equal to what? What is my mass? Capital M. D is equal to, and this is Z is equal to number of atoms per unit cell. That also I'll write it down. This is a heading in this. Number of atoms per unit cell. So guys, no need to worry. What I'm going to tell you, or that only will come for the examination. Okay, density is equal to mass by volume. Mass by volume. I'm just multiplying this by Z. And now what I will do is, I will replace this M with the Avogadro number, M by Na. This M I'm replacing with this particular thing. I'll just show you that. So Z by A cube is equal to into this M by Na, I'll write it. This is my density formula. Z by A cube into M by Na, that's all. This is the formula which is required. D is equal to Z by A cube into M by Na. And you can see one question here. This question will be asked either for board exam or for entrance examination. Nothing we had to do. We had to just substitute the values in this. Okay. An element crystallizes in FCC. And as an edge length. Edge length, we know what is edge length. A, right? A is edge length. A is 0.56 nanometer. So into meter, I'll multiply by 10 power minus 9. Correct? That's all. Calculate density of the element. Density I have to calculate, fine. Molar mass is given as what? 40 gram per mole. Avogadro number, we all know what it is. 6.023 into 10 power 23. That's all. Okay. And this Z. For FCC, Z is equal to 4. For FCC, our Z is equal to 4. Okay. And for BCC, Z is equal to 1. So that we are not going to discuss it now. For this question, it is FCC. So Z is equal to 4. So simple substitution, D is equal to what? 4 into molar mass is 40. 4 into 40 divided by A cube. Correct? So 0.56 into 10 power minus 9. 0.56 into 10 power minus 9. The whole cube into what? What did it write? By Na I have to write off. The Avogadro number thing. Into the Avogadro number. 6.023 into 10 power 23. This is not required. So guys, please calculate and let me know the answer of this. So let me know the answer for the same. So I think how many of you got the answer as 151.26 into 10 power 4 or 151 into 10 power 4, whatever it is. Yeah. 150 into 10 power 4 is also fine. Or 152917. Okay, if you are not converting also, no problem. Only one student has told me the answer. What about others? So guys, just listen here. Yeah, fine, fine. Everyone, please listen here now. Okay. Just listen here only one. In this question, it is FCC. FCC means Z is equal to 4 should come. BCC, z is equal to 2 should come. Simple cubic, z is equal to 1 should come. Okay, this is the first thing which I want to teach you. And while if I'm preparing for entrance examination, oh, this is a board exam as well as entrance examination question. Okay, right. So d is equal to z by a cube into m by na. Avogadro number we already know. 6.023 and 10 power 23. This is 10 power minus 23 is what 10 power minus 27 will get. Fine. So that's not a problem for us. Molar mass is given in the question 40. A cube. Edge length is A. That's all. This is a question which I want to introduce today. And coming to this explanation of each and everything. Packing efficiency is nothing but how much or this full space, correct? How much particles can accommodate in this full space? Or else the total space accommodated by the filled by the particles. It's called packing efficiency. Total space filled by the particles. This is called packing efficiency. So edge length of the cube is A. This is R. The formula is volume one atom to the total volume unit cell. If it is simple cubic, it will be one atom. If it is body centered cubic, it will be 2 atoms. So 2 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. If it is for FCC, it will be 4 atoms. 4 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. Correct? And I have to get the volume of the unit cell. That is A cube I have to get. A. A is equal to 2r in this question. First question. A is equal to 2r. So 2r the whole cube. I'm just substituting and I'm just getting it. That's all. I got 52.4% for the simple cubic. Second thing is what packing efficiency in body centered cubic lattice. Fine. So in triangle EFD, FD square is equal to EF square plus ED square. Why I am again going to find this thing? Because I want something in terms of R. Because in body centered, it is 2 into 2 by 3, 2 into 4 by 3 pi R cube. Correct. I want A in terms of what? R I need. So I have to cancel it. So first what I do, I find a relationship between B and A, correct? But again, this is not R. Then I take one more triangle AFD. From there, I get something called C. But C is a very important thing here. C has got 4R. So this 4R, the this C square is equal to 3A square. And but C is equal to what? 4R. So from this, I'm getting my R. You got the clarity now. So for this only, I'm converting A in terms of R so that I can cancel these things and get the final answer. Now, is it clear for everyone? Is this clear? So I'll just pause the record. Z is equal to 2 for BCC. And what is Z is nothing but number of atoms per unit cell. So you may get either BCC or FCC in your question. But the formula is same.